fun in the KARE 11 barn, and we are going to get smarter in a short amount of time. And we have some great friends here from Solar Bear and Native Sun. I'll start with you first, Ralph. Okay, so tell me, what does Solar Bear do?
We are a development company. And actually, Bob Blake, the owner, has hired a bunch of, well, let's say three of us who are veterans of the solar industry who are now semi-retired. And really, our job is to help indigenous communities in Minnesota get the benefits of an electric power system that usually puts them at a disadvantage, where they're located closer to the power plants. Prairie Island has a nuclear power plant and nuclear waste in their backyard. Well, most of us don't want to live next to that. So they have to actually get the benefits. So what we do is we provide training for members of the tribe so that they can get hired on crews. And actually, Native Sun, I mean, we do part of it, like the hands-on part. They do the arrangements. So what we need to do is distinguish what the development company does and what the nonprofit does.
We always talk about how it takes teamwork to make the dream work. So tell me a little bit about Native Sun.
Okay, so we are harnessing renewable energy with Native communities. And we're also building a Native workforce. We do training and workforce development and courses from Native communities and at Native communities. We're also working on K-12 education and leadership skills in environmental avenues.
Today we've learned more about new food that I know I had never tried. We're learning about new resources that have been doing the work. Why is it so important to have these resources and to know about them, especially for our indigenous communities?
Ani, and I'm Joe Parkhurst from Red Lake, dual citizenship American and from Red Lake Nation in northern Minnesota. And this work is real important to me because it's about taking care of our community, and that's why I joined Bob in this effort. It's important that we make sure that future generations have some place to call home. That's why.
Man, there's so many amazing things happening. You all, before we wrap up, what's one thing that you want everyone to keep in mind as they learn more about your work?
You know, I think that Native communities are where there's a lot of experimentation going on about culture and technology, because they don't just accept every new technology. They're a little like the Amish, you know. They got to look at it and figure out where it fits in their community. And I think that's actually what requires a respectful relationship. And so energy sovereignty is something that each Native community is exploring right now, what it means for them and how they can actually take more control of their energy future.
Oh, man. And just like that, we've been having so much fun. Our time is up. You all give it up for Solar Bear and Native Sun. We have so many cool things that we have been learning. Matter of fact, give me your last thing that you want everyone to be thinking of.
Okay, so I'm Lisa Daniels. I've worked in wind energy and renewable energy for many, many years. And there is so much we can do, we can all do in our everyday lives to help protect the earth and to help maintain a balance so that we don't edge towards that tipping point any more than we already are. So look around you, figure out what to do, and like they were saying on the DNC the other night, just do something that works towards the transition of clean energy.
And of course, when it comes to meeting with community and learning about new communities, what's one thing that people should take away from today?
We're all here together. So we have differences, and those differences should be enjoyed and celebrated. And we're all friendly neighbors. That's my view of things.
Oh, man. Do you all feel like you got a little smarter in a short amount of time? Yes, yes, yes. And I know that you all continue to work together. So electric cars, that's your thing.
Oh, yes. Yes, we have two projects right now that are funded by the U.S. Department of Energy. It's an Electric Nation project that's at Red Lake Nation and Standing Rock, Minnesota, North Dakota, South Dakota, and Wisconsin and Michigan.
Oh, man. And then last thing that you all have working on in Solar Bear?
Well, actually, because the federal government is trying to get a lot of money out the door before the election, they've been telling us you know, apply for all those grants from the Bureau of Indian Affairs, the Department of Energy, the Federal Energy Management Administration, Emergency Management.
And that's...
So we're applying for, like, tens of millions of dollars worth of grants.
And we love to see it. Hey, be encouraged. Check us out tomorrow. And, of course, come to the KARE 11 Barn to see the manias as well.